A 10-year-old girl on a mission to give thousands of art kits to kids in need. And a couple married for 67 years celebrates their reunion after a COVID scare. On today's In This Together, presented by Ulta Beauty. Hey guys, and welcome to In This Together. I'm Sally Turner. For our first story today, we are following one girl's incredible journey as she gives the gift of art to kids in need. 10-year-old Chelsea Fair not only has a love of art, she also has a charitable heart.
Art helps me communicate when I can't. It helps me express myself when I need to. And when none can hear me, I feel that art is my voice. And it's helped me get through so many tough times. And I want everyone to be able to have the gift of art. 2 years ago, I received a very elaborate art kit from a family friend. And my mom was like, "Don't break all those crayons, not everyone has these things." I was like, "What do you mean everyone doesn't have art kits like these?" We had to have a conversation that everyone doesn't have access to art materials, and that made me very sad.
She convinced her parents to help her form Chelsea's Charity to provide free art kits to kids in foster care or experiencing homelessness.
I am an early childhood professor of education, so I teach about methods to use for teachers to use to support children's social emotional development. Art is definitely one of those elements that we talk about to support children. I used to teach first grade, and I remember vividly one of my students was actually expressing herself through a picture that she had never talked about before, and I never would have had that insight had I not really paid attention to her illustration. And she pretty much said, "Well, I just didn't know how to say that. I only knew how to draw it." We recognize that there's a need to support physical development. We realize there's also a need to support the mental health development and social emotional development for children as well.
The kits not only include crayons, markers, and paint, but also canvases, sketch pads, and smocks. Chelsea's mum said these tools can be incredibly helpful to kids during these scary and difficult times.
And I know schools try their best to get all the supplies they could out in such a quick amount of time. I'm not sure how many schools were able to kind of grab art kits or glue or crayons or something that kids didn't have to go online to be able to use. Imagine not having access to these things. And a lot of those materials, some kids only had them in school.
Before the pandemic, Chelsea had given away more than 800 art kits. But in the past 2 months, she's almost doubled that number.
We have given away over 1,500 art kits. People have responded by sending me Google slides and videos of them using their art kits. They have sent me drawings. And one organization in Eastchester sent me a booklet with all of their thank you cards and all their drawings and paintings that they use from the materials from their art kits. And that was really amazing.
We were impressed with her consistency. She had been asking for a number of years to have an opportunity to help and to serve others. She was persistent and she kept saying, "All right, can we start Chelsea's Charity now?" And my husband and I were like, "Oh yeah, we're gonna help you get that started." And finally we realized she's serious about this, and she had the energy and the commitment and the passion to really follow through with it. So we had no choice but to support her. And that makes us proud that she was listening at some point, that we are called to serve and to help each other. And for her to kind of own that and make it her own project, that really meant a lot to us. We can help at any level. It just takes one good act of kindness to support somebody else. And that act of kindness can spark something else, and it just becomes a snowball effect.
We can make a difference despite our age. Doesn't matter how old we are or how young we are. We can make a difference and make the world a better place.
If you would like to support Chelsea's charity, we are going to be leaving a link to that in the comment section below. For our next segment today, we have partnered up with Ulta Beauty to shine a light on beautiful moments of togetherness, joy, and humanity. Our story today follows one couple's emotional reunion after a tough battle with coronavirus. That's 90-year-old Joyce Hoffman walking with pride towards her husband of 67 years. The two had been separated for 5 weeks while Joyce bravely fought and beat COVID-19. After the difficult 5 weeks, the two were overjoyed to see each other again.
I have to cry from happiness. Oh, my word. Oh, honey.
So cute.
Joyce and Don later celebrated her belated 90th birthday with some well-deserved chocolate cake. Such an emotional reunion, and we really do wish Joyce and Don nothing but happiness and healthy days for the future ahead. So that is it for today's show. We hope you enjoyed it, and wherever you're watching, you're making the most of these difficult times, because we are in this together.